Happy Wednesday and welcome to Coffee with Compassion. This morning we're going to spend a few minutes looking at some of the enemies to our peace. Now, yesterday I read John 14 and 27. Jesus said this to his disciples before he went to the cross. He said, "I'm leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid." Now, yesterday we saw that we have initial peace and lasting peace, and it begins with a relationship. We have peace with God through the shed blood of Jesus Christ, and that is the foundation of all peace. Without that relationship, peace can never be obtained in any person's life. Now, once that peace is obtained, we can experience an abiding peace, the peace of mind and heart that Jesus was talking about. Now, that peace transcends all of our circumstances, and we appropriate that type of peace by faith. Faith is the foundation of God's peace. It's having an active, confident trust in His presence and His power to sustain our lives. There are, however, some enemies that undermine our faith and rob us of our peace. So let's look at a few enemies this morning of our peace. Number one, I think the number one enemy is this, it's fear. And I believe that we're all vulnerable to this at times. You know, the storms of life can rise up unexpectedly. And when they come out of nowhere, our first response normally as human beings is to panic. Jesus' disciples reacted that way when they were in a literal storm. They panicked, wondering if Jesus even cared. And He did, and He does, and He cares about you. He cares about me. But one thing we can learn from this experience of His disciples is that they did run to Jesus. They went immediately to Him. We must remember, as we said yesterday, Jesus is our peace, and He is the one that will calm the storm in our life. A second enemy to our peace is the enemy himself, Satan. He seeks to rob us of our peace. He uses various means to bring doubt in our lives. But what we have to do as believers is we have to recognize these doubts and take a stand. Now, quite honestly, some people say that doubt is a sin. I think doubt is a part of the human condition. I think that all of us at times have doubted. I know that I have in my life. But the thing is this, what do we do with the doubts? I think the doubts become sin if we meditate on those doubts and we allow it to become unbelief in our life. But if we recognize the doubts and take a stand, we can take those doubts captive in order to obey Christ. Matter of fact, James said this in James 4 and 7. He said that we could humble ourselves before God, we can resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Come close to God, and God will come close to you. As we humble ourselves, as we draw close to God, He draws close to us. We can take our stand, and the devil will have to flee because he wants no part of God. Number three, a third enemy is sin. Peace cannot coexist when we have sin in our life. And what is our recourse to sin? We have to confess it before God and repent. You know, ask the Holy Spirit when we do repent to help you and empower you to be able to turn away and resist that temptation in your life. Then once again, God's peace can flow in our life. I think the fourth enemy, and I think this is very relevant for the time that we're living, is that we lose focus. See, we can allow the ups and downs of life, we can allow the news of life to begin to consume us. I don't know about you, but during this crisis, I probably paid more attention to the news. And I don't think that's a bad thing. I think that we need to be people that are informed. But at the end of the day, I can't watch but so much of it because all of the bad news that is occurring begins to affect my soul. So we have to be careful. It's important in times like these that we spend time with God, we fix our eyes on Him, and we spend quality time in His Word and His prayer. This morning, as we bring this to a close, I want to assure you of this, that God is with us. We don't have to be defeated by these troubles. We can face every challenge and we can overcome them through Christ. All of these troubles will eventually pass. I want to give you this last scripture, 2 Corinthians 4:16. Therefore, we do not lose heart, for our light and momentary affliction is producing for us an eternal glory that is far beyond comparison. So we fix our eyes on not what is seen, but what is what is unseen. For what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. I don't know what you're personally experiencing, but I want to encourage you, look to Him and look through the eyes of faith. Let His peace guard your heart and your mind. Father, we thank You for this time. We thank You for the assurance that You're with us. And Lord, as we look through the eyes of faith, God, we see You actively working in our life and that You're for us. We love You and we praise You. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Today, be a blessing to somebody. Have a great day and make a difference.